Archie Harrison grew up as fast as he blasted through major milestones. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex's son is growing up quickly. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have kept their family life with son Archie Harrison Mountbatten-Windsor fairly private since they became parents in May 2019. Although he may not have attended as many royal appearances as his cousins Prince George, Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis, Archie's parents have kept fans updated on some of his biggest milestones. From the moment the royal tot was introduced to the world to his first Christmas in America, take a look back at Archie's biggest firsts. Speaking in St. George's Hall at Windsor Castle just 2 days after the birth, and the royal couple looked every inch the doting parents. "It's magic, it's pretty amazing," shared Meghan as her husband held their newborn. "I have the two best guys in the world, so I'm really happy." She added, "He has the sweetest temperament, he's really calm." On the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's podcast Archival Audio, fans got to hear their son speak for the first time in public. Harry can be heard telling Archie, "You can speak into it." Next, Mum Meghan asks him, "Archie, is it fun?" To which he replies, "Fun." The doting dad then encourages him to wish listeners a Happy New Year. Copying his dad, who says, "Happy" into the microphone, Archie repeats the word, "Happy." The Duke says, "New," and Archie replies, "New Year." Not many children get to meet Her Majesty at 2 days old, but Archie is the Queen's 8th great-grandchild. The Queen and Prince Philip were the first royals to meet Archie, with the momentous occasion shared on the Sussex's Instagram account showing the monarch cooing over the famous family's new addition. Meghan looked so proud holding her baby, while her mother Doria Ragland was also pictured in the background. To mark their son's first birthday on the 6th of May 2020, and the royals shared a video of Meghan reading one of Archie's favorite books, Duck Rabbit, as they relax at home. Despite the low-key birthday celebrations amid the pandemic, the couple still managed to catch up with family via Zoom and treat the one-year-old to his first smash cake. And the royal tot was christened during a private ceremony in July, 2 months after his arrival. The intimate ceremony was held in the private chapel at Windsor Castle, attended by fewer than 25 guests and conducted by the Archbishop of Canterbury. Archie looked absolutely adorable in his pristine christening gown, surrounded by his family. And the royals loved playing polo, so it was no surprise to see little Archie join Mum to watch his dad take part in a polo match at Bullingbur Polo Club in Berkshire. Meghan was picture planting a kiss on her baby's head as she carried him from the car, and was joined by Duchess Kate and her children, who were there to watch Prince William, also taking part in the game. During a visit to a community centre in Windsor in November 2019, Meghan revealed that her son had started teething. A clip shared on the Sussex Royal Instagram account showed the couple talking to a small group of children. The Duchess was heard chatting to one young girl, saying, "Look at all your teeth. Archie just got two teeth, some tiny ones right there," she added, gesturing to her bottom gum. "We saw lots of cute Archie on the family's royal tour of Africa in September." The then 4-month-old joined his parents as they met with Archbishop Desmond Tutu, with Archie looking happy and content in his mother's arms. Earlier in the day, Meghan had opened up about life as a parent when she and Harry met a Muslim Cape Town family. Wasifa Majid, a friend of the hosts, said of Meghan, she was speaking about motherhood and the transition, and said that Archie was a good traveler. She said the transition was quite smooth, because he is an easy baby and he was an easy traveler. Harry said he slept on his chest almost 11 hours during the flight. A baby's first Christmas is a really special time for a family, which was clear to see on the Sussex's family Christmas card. The then 7-month-old royal smiled for the camera wearing a knitted sweater by Bowden as he made a beeline for the camera. The photo was captured by Meghan's friend Janina Gavinka, and captures an intimate family moment, likely taken during their time off in Canada. In November 2019, Harry and Meghan revealed that Archie had reached a new milestone, as they surprised military families in Windsor during a visit to the Broom Farm Community Centre, and the royals chatted to families of service personnel who are currently deployed overseas, with Meghan saying that Archie, then 6 months old, was starting to crawl. Fellow mum Mamie Thompson said, "My daughter Eris is the same age as Archie and we talked about weaning. and the children beginning to crawl. She's just a normal mum and it was like talking to a friend. Or, Archie got into the spirit of the Rugby World Cup in November 2019, when he dumped and England were big row. In an interview with the Daily Telegraph, Brian E. Gordon wrote, "Meghan tells me that while her husband has flown to Japan in his role as a patron for the RFU, she and Archie will be watching the Rugby World Cup final tomorrow morning." Archie in an England bibigroga England, she beams. 5-month-old Archie sounded like such a sweetie. Speaking on ITV documentary Harry and Meghan, An African Journey, the Duke of Sussex revealed that his baby boy was making more noise than he ever has before during the family's royal tour of Southern Africa. Noting that Archie clearly loves Africa as well, Harry added, "He was looking out the window. He has found his voice now and he was bouncing up and down. He was making more noise than he has ever made before and he is smiling the whole time." As they celebrated their first Christmas together in the US, Harry and Meghan released a festive family card with Archie in the garden of their California home. In the artistic rendering, and the royal couple were pictured in jeans and their little boy, dressed similarly casually, was held by his dad as his mum reached an arm out to him. During the Sussex's 6-week winter break in 2019, little Archie had a major first when it comes to natural scenery. Following their holiday, Meghan told diplomats at the Canadian High Commission in London, "My goodness, it was just such an incredible time we were able to have there and with our son too. And just to be able to take in the warmth that we experienced from the people, also just walk around and just see the beauty of Canada. To see Archie go ah when you walk by and just see how stunning it is, so it meant a lot to us." At 9 months old, Archie has already set eyes on snow. Prince Harry revealed the exciting milestone at a private fundraiser for his charity Centre Bale at the Ivy Chelsea Garden. Acknowledging the support he has received over the years, Harry revealed, "It has also been a privilege to meet so many of you. And to feel your excitement for our son Archie, who saw snow for the first time the other day and thought it was bloody brilliant. We all remember the first time our stabilizers came off our bike and little Archie isn't far off that moment." When making their first televised interview earlier this year, Prince Harry told Oprah Winfrey how he, Meghan and Archie are loving the lifestyle in LA, being able to enjoy outdoor space, go for walks or go down to the beach which is so close. The proud father added how his personal highlight is being able to go on a bike ride with his son, something he wasn't able to do himself as a child. Thank you for watching. If you like our video, would you please help us like, share and subscribe our channel? Wish you happy to see our videos. Thank you very much.